Prostatic hyperplasia BPH. It's a very common benign condition of the prostate and it occurs in the men over 50 years of age, and by the age of the 60 years 50% of the men have histologically evident BPH. It's a common cause of the significant lower urinary tract symptoms in men and is the most common cause of the bladder outflow obstruction. This is the testosterone dependent benign tumor, and it produced by the testosterone, excessive excretion of the testosterone. Hypothalamus releases luteinizing hormone, which acts on the anterior pituitary, which releases the luteinizing hormone, which acts on the Leydig cells of the testes, and Leydig cells of the testes produces testosterone. With the advancing age, the testosterone levels although decreases slowly, but significantly decrease of the estrogenic steroids does not occur, and they do not decrease equally. So the prostatic enlargement is because of the increased estrogenic effects. Testosterone is converted into the 5-dihydroxy testosterone, which is the active form of the testosterone, by 5-alpha reductase, which is produced from the prostate. And 5-dihydrotestosterone acts on the glandular epithelium and connective tissue stroma. So, and it mostly affects the transitional zone of the prostate gland, and transitional zone submucous glands enlarge and form the valves of the loops, which causes enlargement of the prostate gland. Now, components. It has two components, mechanical component and dynamic component. Mechanical component of the BPH are produced by the prostate, and it causes the mechanical obstruction of the bladder outflow, and symptoms of the BPH, which are the low urinary tract symptoms. Dynamic component is produced due to the smooth muscle contraction in the prostate and bladder neck, which also leads to the resistance to the outflow of the urine. Symptoms can be due to the voiding difficulty and the storage insufficiency. Due to the storage insufficiency causes irritative symptoms like dysuria, frequency, urgency, nocturia, urgence, incontinence, nocturia and incontinence. And voiding difficulty causes obstructive symptoms, hesitancy, which means that patient has to wait for the urination to start, and it worsen if bladder is very full. Poor flow or poor stream, which means that a decreased urine flow with less caliber of the stream, which is unimproved by straining. Intermittent stream, steam stops and start and during the micturition, and dribbling, including after micturition, after finishing, drops fall after the end of the urination. Incomplete emptying, there is a sensation of poor bladder emptying, and then the urine retention. Dysuria means that there is painful urination. Frequency means abnormally short time between voiding. Urgency means being unable to hold urine after feeling the need to pass urine. Urge incontinence, urge leading to the urine leakage, and nocturia being woken in the night by the need to pass the urine. Now for the diagnosis of the BPH, first of all we take the history of the patient, and in the history there is important score which is called the IPSS, International Prostate Symptom Score. Here is the IPSS score system is given. Patient is given a flow chart to fill for the whole month, and at the end of the month score is calculated. Score is the variables used are the incomplete emptying, frequency, intermittency, urgency, weak stream, straining and nocturia. And following scoring is used, and then total IPSS score is calculated. Total score is 0 to 7, it means that there are mild symptoms, and if score is between 8 to 19, it shows there are moderate symptoms, and 20 to 35 score represent the severe symptoms. This IPSS score gives information about the severity of the symptoms at the outset and changes over the time and following intervention. The IPSS assessment should include an assessment of quality of life, which is a reflection of the degree of bother caused by a patient's symptoms. Now, after history examination is performed, which could be the abdominal, digital rectal examination and neurological examination. In abdominal examination, distended bladder is seen on palpation or percussion if there is chronic retention of the urine, and loss of transverse suprapubic skin crease is evident. On digital rectal examination is performed for the assessment of the size and feature of the malignancy. Its surface could be the hard and nodular, and obliterated median sulcus could be present, and there could be the fixed mucosa. In benign enlargement, posterior surface is smooth, convex and elastic, but may be hard due to the fibrous element. Rectal mucosa can be made to move over the prostate, and residual urine may be felt as a fluctuating swelling above the prostate. It should be noted that if there is considerable amount of the residual urine is present, it pushes the prostate downward, making it to appear larger than it is. Neurological examination is done to assess any neurological lesion causing the urinary retention symptoms. Neurological diseases and metabolic diseases like diabetes mellitus, Tape's dorsalis, disseminated sclerosis, cervical spondylosis, Parkinson's disease and other neurological states may mimic the prostatic obstruction. If they are suspected, then a pressure flow urodynamic study should be carried out to diagnose the bladder outflow obstruction. And examination of the perianal sensation and anal tone is used for the detection of an S2 to S4 caudal lesions of the spinal nerves. Blood test is performed for the assessment of the urea, creatinine, electrolytes and hemoglobin. These are mainly done to assess the kidney function and electrolyte imbalances. In urine tests, glucose, blood like RBCs and pus cells are seen in the urine examination. Midstream specimen is used for the bacteriological examination, and urine culture for the infection is done. And in the suspicion of the carcinoma in situ, cytological examination of the urine is performed. Ultrasonography is done to check the size of the prostate, post void volume, which is the residual urine of the bladder, which should be the normally less than 50 millimeter. If it is more than 100 ml, then it represents the bladder outflow obstruction. Prostate specific antigen, its serum value normally is less than 4 nanogram per ml. If it is 4 to 10 nanogram per ml, it shows the infection, and if it is more than 20 nanogram per ml, then it shows the prostatic carcinoma suspicion. Increased PSA necessitates the transrectal ultrasound scanning, and transrectal ultrasonography guided needle biopsy for the prostate to exclude any carcinoma or any malignancy. Flow rate measurement is performed, and it is done during the voiding. It is measured during the voiding, and it is meaningful For this to be meaningful, at least 2 to 3 voids should be recorded using a special flow meter, which is found in the urology outpatient clinics, and then voided volume should be in excess of 150 to 200 ml. Normally, rate is more than 20 ml per second, and voided volume in excess of the 150 to 200 ml. But if there is bladder outflow obstruction symptoms or detrusal instability or weak bladder contraction, then it could be less than 10 ml per second. While voiding volume is in excess of more than 200 ml. Pressure flow urodynamic studies. This urodynamic study is helpful in differentiating the various causes of the low urinary tract symptoms, as this can occur in the overactive bladder, stress incontinence, and bladder outflow obstruction. Pressure in the bladder and abdomen are recorded while the bladder is filled, which is called the systometry, and emptied pressure flow studies. Normally, pressure should not exceed 60 centimeter of water in men and 40 centimeter of water in women. But if pressure is more than 60 centimeter of water, it indicates that there is an increased pressure, and which could be due to the bladder outflow obstruction. Pressure flow urodynamic studies are done in the men with suspected neuropathy like Parkinson's disease, dementia, diabetes mellitus, which is long standing, multiple sclerosis and previous stroke, if there is a dominant history of the irritative symptoms, if there is doubtful history and flow rate in near or normal near range, which is more than 15 ml per second, or we can say more than 20 ml per second. If flow rate measurement are in normal range, but there is doubtful history and there are clinical symptoms present, then we perform the pressure flow urodynamic studies. And if there is invalid flow rate measurement because of the decreased voided volume, as we see earlier, that there should be the excess of the voided volume of 150 to 200 ml at least. Then cystourethroscopy. It is a visual inspection of the urethra, prostate and urothelium of the bladder. Immediately, it has to be performed immediately prior to the prostatectomy, which could be transurethrally and open route. From these two routes, cystourethroscopy can be performed, and it is performed to rule out the urethral strictures, bladder carcinoma, and non-opaque vesical calculus or bladder stones. Now, management of the BPH. First of all, watchful waiting is done for the mild symptoms. In whom the symptoms IPSS score is less than 7. These patients are instructed on behavioral techniques to reduce the symptoms, which may be the reduction of the fluid intake at bedtime, reduction of the alcohol and caffeine consumption, and if symptoms worsen, then medical therapy is implied. Medical therapy is used for the mild to moderate symptoms, and in those men who are very concerned about the development of the sexual dysfunction after transurethral resection of the prostate. For these two drugs, alpha blockers and 5-alpha reductase inhibitors are used. Alpha blockers used are doxazosin, terazosin, temsulosin. These all relaxes the smooth muscle in the prostate and the bladder neck, and relieving the dynamic component of the BPH causes the obstruction to relieve. These drugs act rapidly, and they are indicated in the moderate size prostate causing mild to moderate symptoms. The main side effect is the postural hypotension, and these drugs should be administered at the bedtime. Now, 5-alpha reductase inhibitors, they inhibit the conversion of the testosterone to more potent 5-alpha dihydrotestosterone. As we have seen here, that conversion of the testosterone to active form of 5-dihydroxytestosterone is important to growth of the glandular epithelium and connective tissue stroma. So if we inhibit the 5-alpha reductase enzyme, then conversion of the testosterone to 5-dihydroxytestosterone could not be occur, and it cannot act on the epithelium and stroma, and prostate size does not increases. So these drugs decreases the size of the prostate gland, but their onset of the action is very slow, and they have to be given for the prolonged time, that is more than 6 months. These are indicated in the men with large prostate, causing mild to moderate symptoms. Surgical treatment is done in the patients with failed medical treatment, or in those patients who themselves desire for the surgical removal of the prostate gland. The main surgical procedure then done is the prostatectomy, which is the removal of the prostate gland, and it is done by the following techniques. Indications for the surgery are bothersome low urinary tract symptoms, very severe symptoms where medical treatment has failed, recurrent acute retention or renal failure due to the bladder obstructive uropathy. When there is obstruction, there is a backflow of the urine, and which causes the hydronephrosis, hydroureters, and kidney failure can also occur. Chronic retention and renal impairment, where the residual volume is more than 200 ml, raised urine creatinine, hydroureter, and hydronephrosis develops. Complications of the BPH, which could be that stone formation or recurrent infections, hemorrhage, and patient's choice elective surgery is done. Following techniques are used for the prostatectomy. Number one is transurethral resection of the prostate, which is the gold standard. Number two is transvesical prostatectomy. Number three is retropubic prostatectomy. Number four is modern minimal invasive endoscopic technique. Newer techniques used are laser treatment, which is HOLAP, and KTP green light. HOLAP is a holium laser enucleation of the prostate, and KTP is green light laser. It vaporizes the tissues and has deeper penetration than the holium, and make it suitable for the vaporization of the prostate tissue. Transurethral electrovaporization of the prostate, transurethral needle ablation of the prostate, transurethral microwave thermotherapy. Intrauterine stents are used in the men with retention who are grossly unfit for thus any surgical treatment. After treatment, most urologists irrigate the bladder with sterile saline by using three-way Foley catheter for 24 hours or so.